An ideal principal thus must not cling to the obsolete methods and be flexible to the transitions of the novel century. He must be a man of vision. An ideal principal provides his school with a vision by being collaborative, responsive, and transparent as he weaves the path for his school to follow based on sound research, consultation, and experience. He should be actively engaged. This shift to the new millennium style of teaching is possible only when the principal is actively engaged in the learning of his staff and students through digital analysis and access to a broader spectrum of knowledge. He should understand that the more tools and exposure students have, the more creative and innovative they will be. He should be one with a humane touch. Now, in an attempt to develop communication, that is sharing of thoughts, collaboration, that is working together towards a goal, critical thinking, that is looking at situations from a different point of view, and creativity, that is trying new approaches, it has resulted in an overloaded curriculum for the students. This can be intercepted only when the principal is compassionate and understands that his students' lives extend beyond the walls of the school. He should encourage them not to cram things, but to know the practical uses of the knowledge imparted to them. He should empower teachers as facilitators. Each child is unique and one size doesn't fit all. Thus, every student needs to be approached in a way he finds interesting. In this case, an ideal principal's role is to empower teachers as facilitators and help them make learning experiences relevant, holistic, and interesting. Relevant here means that students must be able to relate with what they are taught at school and what they practice in everyday life. Holistic refers to the all-round development of the student and not just the intellectual skills. They should also be well-equipped with vocational skills and life skills. And interesting, as we all know, students must be able to accept the knowledge they are being given. An ideal principal should be a skilled negotiator and thoughtful moderator. With the growing challenges faced by students and staff, an ideal principal should be able to approach situations from both sides, weigh the options, and make sound decisions. He must be firm but fair. Besides being effective, he should encourage parents to be collaborators of the school, as teachers, students, and parents form the three vertices in the triangle of education. Now, I'd like my teammate Niharika Sharma to continue with the rest of the presentation.
Thank you. So, an ideal school principal should be an effective listener. In this 21st century, he should be able to maintain clear lines of honest communication and be open to suggestions so as to suspend unbiased judgment. Besides being an effective listener, he should also be approachable at all times. And of course, a sense of humor and an adorning smile can go a long way. An ideal school principal should be able to create an atmosphere of peaceful coexistence among staff and students. He should be able to demonstrate the importance of having faith in one another by strengthening ethical goals and standards. And undoubtedly, an ideal school principal should be a role model for everyone. Especially in this modern era, when students are getting more and more alienated from the studies due to addiction to mobile phones and televisions, an ideal school principal should be able to inspire students to stress on the proper use and not misuse of the technologies available. He should be able to discourage rote learning and teach students to respond to rapid changes happening in everyday life. An ideal school principal should be a dynamic administrator. He believes that a school operates in an environment that is both proactive and reactive, that a course of action may need to be altered in a moment's notice. An ideal school principal is also aware and abides by the district policies and pertinent state laws, as he is the backbone of the administrative body of the school. This includes laws such as proper infrastructure, well-equipped with first aid kit, ensuring child safety, well-lit and ventilated classrooms, and well-trained and sensitized staff. At the same time, he also ensures that the necessary child rights are respected within the school premises. This includes rights such as right to a childhood, right to be treated fairly, and right to be educated. He should also ensure that the school is covered under the child protection policy, which secures every child of any form of abuse, be it sexual, verbal, mental, or physical. At a time when one can learn almost anything by watching a YouTube video, an ideal school principal emphasizes on the role of a good quality teacher in encouraging students with broader interests to go beyond their parents and teachers. He should ensure that they have the necessary skills and confidence to face every challenge in life in a positive way. Lastly, I'd like to conclude by saying that the duty of a principal is not to prepare students for something. His duty is to help students prepare themselves for anything.